On his first full day in office, President Obama issued a memorandum on transparency and open government. This memorandum was engineered to make sure that the federal government changed its default setting from closed, secretive, and opaque to transparent, open, and participatory.
If you'd like to see an excellent example of this, visit www.cms.gov/dashboard. The dashboard was developed by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, or CMS, the agency in Health and Human Services that provides health coverage to our most vulnerable citizens.
We've already seen the power of dashboards. Last year, the administration deployed the IT dashboard to shine light on over $76 billion of IT spending. As soon as the dashboard was launched, we saw agency after agency evaluate every single IT investment across the federal government. The Veteran Administration terminated over $54 million of IT projects. Imagine what this could do for our healthcare system as we think about delivering better healthcare across the country. Imagine if you're able to go online and compare the cost of a knee surgery, whether it's in Seattle or in Boston, whether it's in Los Angeles or in North Carolina. Democratizing data and shining light on the operations of CMS is going to allow the American people to engage and see where their taxpayer dollars are being spent and what types of results they're producing.
When we release, or as I say, liberate data, we're not just being accountable. We're convening a network of users from all walks of life who see the information as a catalyst for improving healthcare in America. As we drive down the long road to true data democracy, I hope you'll follow our progress and share your insights and encouragement by visiting the CMS websites and Health and Human Services Open Government site, www.hhs.gov/open.
The Medicare dashboard is different from the other data sets and comparison tools on our CMS and Medicare.gov websites. The big difference is we've put effort into designing a website that's easy to use. The site uses over 40 million Medicare hospital admissions to visualize the relationship between the cost and volume of Medicare admissions by state, going back to January 2006. And every month, the data is updated with nearly 1 million more admissions.
The beauty of this dashboard is that it shortcuts the current complex process of pulling together this data. Currently, a programmer, Medicare expert, and significant IT support is necessary. This information is now a click away from the user. The dashboard graphs can help researchers, analysts, and managers set the agenda for health policy, systems, and effectiveness research. It can also help journalists inform the public. Health professionals can use the information to develop improvement projects and grant applications, while consumers in some states can use this site and the CMS Hospital Compare site to talk to their doctor about which hospital they want to be admitted to. When a hospital sends Medicare a bill, the diagnosis and treatment information and certain hospital costs assign the admission to a diagnosis-related group, or DRG. The DRG and other adjustments based on the characteristics of the hospital and the patient's stay determine how much Medicare pays. The dashboard site drills down to the top 25 DRGs per state by cost and by volume, and the top 10 hospitals for each of the 25 of those DRGs.
Factors other than the DRG affect total payment. Adjustments are based on whether a hospital is a teaching hospital or serves a disproportionate share of low-income patients. Payments are also based on a hospital's capital costs. Hospitals get an additional payment for cases that are unusually costly, which are called outliers. There are limitations you need to understand before you compare a state dashboard data. The dashboard only uses admissions for people in the original or fee-for-service Medicare program. It doesn't include admissions for people in the Medicare Advantage program. Differences in volume may be driven by differences in enrollment in Medicare Advantage. Differences in total payment may be due to the payment adjustments I mentioned earlier. The dashboard data have not been risk adjusted for patient characteristics. The patterns you see among the states could look different if variations in patient characteristics were taken into account. The data for 2006 represents only 9 months of the fiscal year. Admission data is not considered complete until 18 months after the start of the year, so fiscal year 2009 would not be complete until April of 2010.
you like the Medicare dashboard, visit these other open government sites, www.data.gov, and my favorite site, www.hhs.gov/open.